You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said, or you got a friend in me.
Good morning, Gallup High School. My name is Connor.
And I'm Lance. Would everyone please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Would everyone please remain standing for a moment of silence?
Good morning, Colonel. Would everyone please raise their right hand and repeat the Bok pledge with us? I promise to be accepting, responsible, and kind. Everyone can now be seated.
Let's go over to our weather center. What's going on outside today, Aiden?
Good morning, everyone. Here's today's weather. Now back to the studio.
Thanks, Aiden. It's now time for our morning announcements. Here is today's lunch menu. Coming up, School Star will be open on Thursdays and
check out some of our second grade friends. They put together a musical production of So Tell by themselves. I went to the teacher and asked her, could we make a musical? And she said, get some friends, and we started. Talk about taking risks.
2, 1, go. The world needs you. So tell me.
Hello, Gallup Hill School. My name is Emma.
And my name is Joyce.
Every day in Ms. Rogers' fourth grade class, we listen to a podcast called Kids News. It is a 5-minute broadcast that delivers current events in a kid-friendly way. It sparks our curiosity, leads to discussions, and most importantly, keeps us connected with the world around us.
We listen to the 5-minute broadcast, then we do a quick and fun quiz to see if we remember key facts from the news. After the quiz, the podcast does a shout out to kids and classrooms. Last week, our class was given a shout out and we all went crazy. We had been waiting for a long time to hear our names.
We all continue to listen each day to help us be aware of what's happening in our world. You should check it out.
Good morning and welcome to Kid News. I'm Tori. It's Thursday, January 30th, 2020, and we begin with NASA pulling the space plug on one of its tried and true eyes in the sky. Sometime today, ground controllers in Cape Canaveral will put the Spitzer telescope into something called permanent hibernation, which basically means a floating forced retirement. Spitzer was only supposed to last about 5 years when it launched back in 2003. Instead, it tripled its lifespan and, while scanning the skies with an infrared camera, took spectacular pictures of the star-forming region known as the Tarantula Nebula, discovered a huge, nearly invisible ring around Saturn, as well as 7 Earth-sized planets, and was instrumental in at least 9,000 scientific studies. 4 months ago, 13-year-old Logan Rad was in a Florida emergency room getting stitched up after a shark took a few nibbles of his foot. While that kind of brush with nature might keep many of us out of the water, that wasn't the case with Logan. This week, he captured top honors in the under-14 division of a major surfing competition. The homeschooled seventh grader admits he still gets a little spooked if he sees a shark, but otherwise he says he's fully recovered from the bite, which required 19 stitches. His coach says Logan is an up-and-coming amateur star, and his mom says just in the past year he's grown 4 inches and put on 20 pounds, allowing him to hang 10 even better. No, the coronavirus that's been in the news lately doesn't have anything to do with Corona beer. It seems like that should be obvious, but judging by the dramatic spike in Google searches for beer virus, it's not. The World Health Organization, meantime, continues to monitor the spread of cases around the globe and has yet to decide whether to declare a health emergency. Many businesses aren't taking chances. With 99% of cases confined to China, Starbucks has decided to close half its stores there, while American Airlines, Delta, United, and British Airways are all restricting flights to and from that country. A Minnesota woman's kind-hearted efforts is spreading a lot of warmth during these cold winter months. Michelle Christensen started a scarf-bombing movement in her community last year, which basically means she collects donations of scarves and then wraps them around trees and railings in parks all over the Minneapolis area so anyone who needs one can help themselves. Initially, about 40 volunteers helped her distribute thousands of scarves. This year, the scarf bombing movement has grown to include hats, gloves, and even winter coats. This Sunday is Groundhog Day, and according to legend, if a groundhog sees his shadow, there'll be 6 more weeks of winter. Since 1886, the Pennsylvania town of Punxsutawney has held a big ceremony every February 2nd where a furry forecaster, dubbed Punxsutawney Phil, is grabbed by a man in old-fashioned attire, raised overhead before a large crowd, and the groundhog's weather prediction is announced. However, one group is hoping to end this tradition. PETA, which stands for People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals, is calling on the Punxsutawney Groundhog Club to replace the live rodent with a robotic groundhog that could use artificial intelligence to predict the arrival of spring. No response yet from the club or the groundhog. That's it for Kid News. Now, the Kid News Quiz. What's the name of the spacecraft that NASA is retiring today? The Spitzer Telescope. How is a Minnesota woman helping keep her community warm this winter? She started a scarf bombing movement, leaving scarves, mittens, and coats around local parks. A Florida boy recently bitten by a shark just went on to do what? Win a surfing competition. Does the coronavirus have anything to do with Corona beer? No, it does not. And one for the road. Turning 100 years old this year, the Jungle Gym. Sebastian Hinton of Illinois filed the patent for his invention in 1920 and described it at the time as a climbing apparatus that would allow kids to play like monkeys in a jungle. Today, the Jungle Gym and its many variations are one of the most common and most popular structures in playgrounds around the world. Before we go, we'd like to give a Kid News shout-out to Mrs. Rogers' fourth-grade class at Gallup School in Ledyard, Ms. Margario's fourth-grade class at Jerseyville East Elementary, and Mrs. Jensen's fifth-grade class at Helen Keller Elementary in Franklin. Thanks for listening. We hope you tune in for more Kid News tomorrow morning.
That's all for our program today. Thanks for listening.
Thanks, everyone. Have a great day.
Bye. Bye.
Shalom.